We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting, dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello, and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we are looking at Cold Blood Samurai. This is written by Massimo Rosi, pencils by Ludovica Ceregatti, colors by Renato Stevanato, lettering by Mattia Gentili. I'm sure I got most of those names wrong, and I apologize. The editor-in-chief was Sean Gaborin. Publisher was Jason Martin. Marketing director/editor, Nicole D'Andrea. Now, this is from 2019, published by Action Lab Entertainment. I picked this up because I thought, well, the cover's kind of neat. It doesn't really tell you anything about what's going on, but thought it could be cool. And this is a story of feudal Japan just after the Americans forced them to open their borders to trade. So it's sort of a transitional period between feudal Japan and more modern. The shoguns are kind of rebelling. Well, one shogun specifically is rebelling. His name is Swollen Cheeks, and he makes friends with a guy named Short Tail. Unfortunately, Short Tail dies, and there are conflicts to be had, and a Ronin is brought in to solve some problems. This Ronin is referred to as an outsider in a very slur-oriented way, and we see him fighting some crab samurai. And I literally mean crab samurai. He's like a salamander. This is taking some what appear to be similar to historical events and making it more cold-blooded. Literally, most of the Japanese people are shown it to be frogs. There are these crab people, which is obviously another clan of crabs, samurais, and we have this salamander who does not fit in, and they call him an outsider, and it looks like there's a lot of nefarious scheming going on between some of the people in charge and what is meant to be the American ship. As far as I could tell, they're kind of keeping the nations similar, but it's a very interesting story. It's not an action issue. There are some action elements in here, but it's more of a storytelling-oriented book as opposed to an action book. And I have to tell you, I was really, really impressed with this. I thought it was going to be dumb when I got about a third the way in when I realized they actually meant frogs. But it turned out to be very, very interesting, and it's got quite a lot of potential. As long as they don't fall into the trap of being overly politically correct or using modern sensibilities on a past time, I think it could be very, very good. And the art is solid. It really looks like what they're trying to draw. It's got some really good detailing. I really like it quite a bit. I was real impressed with it, and I'm looking forward to reading issue 2. I'm glad I picked this up, and I highly recommend it. If you like samurai stories, this looks like it's going to be for you. And Action Lab doesn't do a whole lot of books, so it might be a little hard to track down, but it will definitely be worth it if you can find it, in my opinion. I was really, really impressed with this. The covers are very simplistic and sort of an abstract look, but I think this is really going to be worth checking out. It doesn't even remotely show how great the interior art is, and if you can track this down for a reasonable price, do so. I did not feel cheated for my $4. I thought this was an incredibly fun book, and I'm planning on picking up issue 2. And if it maintains this level of quality, I will probably add it to my pull list. But that's just my opinion. As always, thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. And we hope to see you on the next one.